taking personal responsibility for your excuses. I've gone to several different schools en route to my two master's degrees, actually five to be exact. And being in class, high-level achievers and lower-level achievers with my broad range of schools that I've attended, I was able to see the difference between the athletes at the highest level and the athletes at lower levels, and also students at the highest level and students at the lower levels. And I would really say this worksheet, this exercise, is the biggest difference between the high-level performers and the lower-level performance, not talent. See, a lot of times when people ask me, well, what's the big difference? It's not so much that the higher level performers are much more talented than the lower level ones. The higher level performers take more responsibility for themselves. They take responsibility for their excuses, and they learn how to work through those excuses. So the simple worksheet exercise that we could do for this, the simple exercise we're going to do is you're going to think about what are your most common excuses that you make in sports, in school, and in life. Maybe it's procrastinating. I'll do it later. Maybe for school, a big excuse for me was saying, I'm never going to use this in life. And maybe that's true, but how's that helping me get better grades? How's that helping me get into college? How's that helping me pave the way to my success that I want? So I need to reframe the way I think about it. So what are the biggest excuses that I tend to make? Also, one of the things now with the training, I might say to myself, well, I don't like lifting weights with my legs. You know, they're really not that important. You know, it's more upper body. I would make all these funny excuses. We all tell ourselves these funny things. Whatever it is, write down your biggest excuses, sports, school, and life. Write out the excuse. And then I want you on the other side of the paper on this exercise to write down, I take personal responsibility for, and then fill in the blank. Write down the opposite. So let's say you're a procrastinator. You say, the excuse, I'll save this till later, or I'll do this tomorrow. That becomes the excuse. The responsibility section becomes, I take personal responsibility for acting now. I take personal responsibility for moving when I feel compelled to move, for starting my action plan, whatever it is. You have to word it the way it works best for you. Maybe for me, if I'm not saying I don't like to work out my legs, if that becomes an excuse for me, you write that down. That's my excuse, that I don't work out my legs, or they're not that important, whatever the case may be. And I say to myself, I take personal responsibility for training my legs. I take personal responsibility for training my whole body, right? Maybe mindset. We say, well, it's tough to train my mindset because I can't see it, because I can't touch it. It's much more in my head. It becomes more theoretical and philosophical and all this psychobabble nonsense, right? We make all these excuses. So we write that down as our excuse and we say, I take personal responsibility for working on my mindset. I take responsibility for understanding the importance of my mindset to my success. I go back to another school example that I just said before. When I say that I'm never going to use this in life, I'm never going to use this subject in life. We learned something in trigonometry. I know I'm never going to use this. That's an excuse. I take personal responsibility for learning each lesson to the best of my ability. I take personal responsibility for my education, whatever the case may be, for learning trigonometry to get me into a better school. So take responsibility. And this might seem like such a simple exercise, but the reason why, and maybe it doesn't even seem like it makes sense, but when you write down, I take personal responsibility for this, you start to retrain your brain and you start to stop letting yourself off the hook and you start taking control of your life. So really this lesson is all about taking the bull by the horns and taking responsibility for our excuses. The hardest part of this whole exercise is going to be spotting your own garbage, all right? Where do I tend to lie to myself? Where do I tend to make excuses? My best recommendation, talk to people who know you well. If you have your accountability buddy, ask your accountability buddy. Ask a parent, ask a sibling, ask a trusted friend. Where do I tend to make excuses? In what areas am I an excuse maker? And be open-minded, listen, write it down on paper. And generally, or you have a significant other, ask them. People will usually tell you if you ask them those things, and then once you take personal responsibility, you're going to be in a much better position to now succeed. Most of us, we want to slide it under the rug. We don't want to do the soul searching. We don't want to dig down deep. This is hard work. It sounds easy. It's hard work to actually go deep inside us and ask, where am I lying to myself? Where am I making excuses? But if you do it, that's going to make a world of a difference, make you much more likely to succeed. Mindset makes the difference. And that's a wrap for today's podcast. I'm Gene Zanetti from Wrestling Mindset.